How much of this shot do you think we actually filmed for real? The answer is it was just me, and everything else was added later. It's Steve from Unexplored Films here, and today we're going to be creating a 3D set extension, a virtual environment to add to a moving shot. Today's video is sponsored by our friends at ProductionCrate, a fantastic all-in-one assets hub for your filmmaking, so stick around to see how they massively helped us with this video. Now, a great way to add production value is to extend the sets or the locations that you have available to you using other elements. And we've touched on this in our previous videos on how to create digital map paintings, and also our video on how to do set extensions for miniatures, so be sure to check those out too. But today we're going to be taking those techniques a step further by trying to create what looks like a 3D environment for a moving character to explore. And all we used to make this was Adobe After Effects and ProductionCrate. So as usual, we're trying to do a lot with a little and prove that you don't always need a big budget to get some really creative filmmaking effects. And if you're enjoying these DIY Hollywood effects and tutorials, please consider subscribing and you'll get to see lots and lots more. So as we wanted to test this concept with a moving shot, we first needed the shot of our character walking forwards, always keeping the same distance away from the camera. Now, we could have filmed this outside, but we wanted to film this in front of a green screen. So how would we make it look like the character was walking? The answer was to simply set up a treadmill in front of the green screen. We faced it forwards because this was pretty much the only angle where you wouldn't see the front of the treadmill, because the high part was at the front. Next, we could set this going on the slowest speed possible, and I could pretty much stay in the same place while looking like I was walking forwards. The challenge then was pretty much just to imagine that I was walking through a strange environment that I hadn't experienced before, instead of just walking on the spot in a room. But the good thing about this technique was that it meant that our lighting could stay consistent, the distance from the camera could stay consistent, and we didn't have to have someone following me around with a green screen outside. So it was a nice quick shoot this time, and once we had a take we were happy with, we could begin the editing. So now we need to find some elements to create our virtual scenery with, and these can be difficult to find and time-consuming to cut out, so rather than trying to build these elements ourselves, we headed over to our sponsor ProductionCrate, where they have an amazing library of elements that you can use to create your own virtual environments and digital set extensions for your films. You'll have seen their effects used in some of our previous videos, and they are such a useful production resource for us with our DIY Hollywood effects videos. They have a huge library of pre-keyed visual effects assets, as well as sound effects and music, and it's all under one affordable subscription, and they also provide lots of free options as well if you just want to create a basic account with them. And if you sign up using our link below this video, they will know we sent you and it helps us out a little bit too. So we had a look through the various categories in ProductionCrate to try and find some elements that we thought would make a good background for this test. In the end, we decided to create a kind of desolate looking landscape with some destroyed buildings and rubble, and we also found some good mountain scenery and sky for the background, and some smaller details like overgrown cables, hanging wires, chain link fences, and barbed wire. They have all kinds of different categories though, so you could easily create almost anything you wanted. We downloaded the high-res versions of all these clips, which you can get with the Pro Access, and then you can make a start arranging these into a nice composition, either in After Effects or in Photoshop. We actually did ours in Photoshop because we were doing a bit more cloning and duplicating and moving things around, and we just decided to do it there first. But wherever you do this, you can still be using that filmmaker's brain to try and find a really nice composition, just as if you were filming this for real. So when we were done, we basically ended up with something like this. We had our sky at the back, and then our hills, then our ground, and then some chimneys and these walls and the rubble, and then close to the front we had some hanging wires, and then at the front we had this kind of brick doorway, which I thought it would be fun for our character to actually step through. So now we can bring our layers into After Effects and begin to animate them. Now, previously we haven't done much with 3D layers in these videos. It tends to just be the x-axis and the y-axis, which is moving up and down and side to side. But if we enable the 3D setting, we now get access to the third dimension, which to Americans and most people is called the z-axis, but us Brits would probably say z-axis. And in this latest version of After Effects, Adobe has added some new camera navigation tools for 3D layers. But before we look at those, we can right-click and create a new camera, and this virtual camera is what's going to allow us to move through the 3D scenery. You can actually change all this information, like the focal length, but we actually left it at 50 because that was pretty similar to what we'd filmed the effect at. And that camera just gets created as a separate layer, and it just can sit on top of all the other layers. So next we wanted to see this scene in 3D space so that we can try and separate out some of these layers. And to do this we can click on this orbit around tool. Now we can see the scene in 3D space, and as you can see all the layers are sticking together. So what we can do now is that we can begin to shift some of these layers backwards and forwards using the Z-axis control. We can actually use these little colored arrows on this thing that's called a gizmo to push and pull the layers in the different directions that we want them in. You can also do this with the keyframes, but if you're more visual, you might just prefer to organize the things just by pulling the arrows around. As the sky is going to be furthest away, we can start by shifting that all the way to the back. And this is, of course, going to make the layers that are further back now seem smaller, so we can compensate for that by making them bigger using the scale control. Now we can shift these other elements further back as well, like the chimneys and the fence and the broken walls. And as we move this around in 3D space, you can see that this is basically beginning to look like scenery on the stage of a theater, which is, of course, pretty much what we're going to use it for. You could even try rotating some elements 90 degrees, like the ground, which we tried here, although you might not see much of it, and this could just be more of an experiment. If you find the orbit tool a bit disorientating, if you click on the tab that says One View, you can choose one of the other options, such as two views horizontal or two views vertical. This will show what your camera is seeing on one side and another point of view of the same scene on the other side. This here is showing what the same scene looks like from the right, and each of the vertical lines represents a different layer. And as I move them around forward and backward, you can see the same thing is happening from what our camera is seeing. So this is another way to not get confused when working in this 3D space. So now we can open up our camera layer and set a keyframe for the position at the beginning and the end of the shot. We left the end keyframe where it was and moved the beginning keyframe forwards. So now we've basically created what looks like a simple dolly move backwards through our digital scenery. Also, we're working with some very high resolution stills from ProductionCrate for this, so these pixelated details won't look like that when we do the final render. So now we were ready to drop in our character filmed on the treadmill, and we remove the background using Keylight. And if you want to learn how to do that in more detail, check out our video on how to add yourself to movies. And with a little bit of adjusting the speed of the camera move, we already have something that looks like a pretty good match for the speed the figure is meant to be walking at. We're also trying to time the moment the character walks through this brick archway with the moment where I look up and around at the ceiling as if I really am walking under something. So when you do your filming, it might be an idea to already have some idea of what scenery is going to belong where in the frame. And that way you can pretend to look at it. So now we need to get all these layers looking a bit more consistent, like they belong in the same frame, because they're all different brightnesses and contrasts. So we can drop our Lumetri color effect onto any of the layers that need it and start doing some minor tweaks. And we mostly lower the exposure on these to darken them down a bit, and we also reduce the contrast. Now it's around this point that you're probably thinking there's something wrong with the sky. And the reason is, of course, the sky doesn't have to get smaller. It can just stay the same size the whole time. So we can actually switch off the 3D layer for the sky and the mountains because they're far enough away that they don't need to get bigger and smaller. But to add a little bit more movement, we can just simply keyframe the sky from left to right just so that it looks like the clouds are moving above the mountains as the camera move happens. So this is starting to look good, but all the elements still look a little bit static, like they could be still images, because of course they are. So we can go back to ProductionCrate and try and find some finishing touches. Now they've got a cool animal section in here, and in it we found a flock of birds flying around, so we thought that could be something moving that distracts your eyes from the fact that lots of these things aren't moving. There's also some things we can add to the foreground, such as maybe using some of these dust or smoke elements to add a little bit of haze and atmosphere into the whole shot. And again, just make all the layers, including the character that I'm playing, look like they're all belonging in the same environment. And remember, if you're adding video layers, conform the frame rate to the same one as your sequence to get the smoothest motion. Finally, if we want to stylize this further, we can drop an adjustment layer on top of everything and again add the Lumetri color to that and do any further color correcting to this layer, which will affect all the layers under it. Then if we want to, we can pre-compose all these layers into a new composition and use the wiggle expression tool just to add a little bit of camera wobble to the entire shot. Finally, we did our sound design, and once again ProductionCrate had everything we needed to make it sound like this character was really in the environment. So that was how we took the footage of our character on the treadmill just in front of a green screen and built an entirely new virtual environment using a 3D digital set extension. So guys, if you enjoyed that, subscribe to the channel and you will see lots more effects and tutorials. I've been Steve from Unexplored Films and I'll see you next time.